So, hey people, what's popping? Kilo Shale, again in name, let's go there. Okay, wonderful people, beautiful people, it is your favorite Achalugo, Chidera Giselle on the microphone. If you are new to my channel, I am Chidera Giselle, a Nigerian lifestyle and fashion vlogger living in Owerri, Imo State. Welcome to my channel. So guys, I am ready to make our Nigerian meat pie. So if you remember my last vlog, I think the last one when I went to the supermarket, I got this Simas butter and I was like, I want to try Auntie Flo's meat pie recipe. I watched the video where she made meat pie inside toaster and I was like, I want to try it, but I'll make the meat pie inside the oven. And I've actually watched like two other of her pie videos this morning, one where she made meat pie with pot and another one where she made chicken pie. That one is an old video, I think 5 years ago or 6 years ago, yeah, 2016. So I've watched about three of her pie videos, like meat pie, meat pie, meat pie, meat pie, meat pie. So I'm sure I'm going to be combining things from the different videos, but the main video I'm going to be using is going to be the toaster own, because I just really loved that recipe, like it's my best among all of them. So I'm not going to be using beef, I'm going to be using chicken. I think I'm talking too much. Without further talk, let us start preparing this wonderful meat pie. Guys, good news, NEPA just brought light now. Like, I've been praying since that, how am I going to bake if there's no light? I just hope the light is still on by the time I'm done prepping everything. Anyways, I want to blend some atarodo, some scotch bonnets that I'll be putting inside the filling. Auntie Flo did not put pepper inside her own, but I usually like all these chicken pie in eateries that have a little bit of pepper, a little bit of everything. So I just want to blend, it's very small, see, like three or four. So I'll blend it now and I'll just proceed, like I'll try and do everything fast. Please NEPA, help me. You should be praying for me wherever you are. Let this light stay for the next 2 to 3 hours, I beg. So I have to take out this food processor engine. What am I supposed to call this? I don't know. I have to take it out, then I'll turn on the blender. When I'm almost done with the dough and the filling, I'll start preheating the oven. I just cleaned it this morning. So I'll plug this. Did you guys just see what happened? Like, the last time I used this blender, I forgot to change the switch to zero. Am I the one that used it last? So immediately I plugged it in, this thing just started doing shoo. Anyways, we're done. Let me go and continue prepping other ingredients. Look at how this grinder grinded this thing smoothly. This grinder has been in this house since, and every time I want to grind pepper, I'll be struggling with blender on, off, on, off. I'll not want to put water, but see this one, no water. Look at how it just grinded it smoothly and neatly, and it came with the blender. Just imagine, many Nigerians always have things that they don't know how to use. So let's continue. This is everything I'm going to be needing for the filling also, I think. Like, one thing about making videos with a recipe is that one thing about cooking with a recipe is that even after watching the recipe like 2 or 3 times while cooking, you still have to be going back to the recipe, because you forget something.
Seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago.
So I have some leftover chicken at home, so I'm going to be using it. See, this one is not enough, I'll take the rest in the pot. So this is something that is quite different from all the recipes I saw, because all the recipes I saw, they used raw chicken, but I don't have raw chicken at home, it's leftover chicken, so I'm still going to use it. Just that I'll use the knife and pieces it, and apart from piecing it with the knife, I think I'm still going to be leaving some big chunks, because I like when I buy chicken pie and I see some chunks. So yeah guys, I'm done shredding the chicken. This is how it is, it's not pieces, but this is how I like chicken inside chicken pie. I like bringing out slices of chicken like this. So I'll be going inside the room right now to go get my soft box.
So I'm here with my LED lights. Did I call it soft box? It's LED lights I meant. So I'm here with the LED lights because where the burner is, that's the gas cooker, is it's quite dark. So I want you guys to see everything I'm doing, and God has mercy. God has had mercy on me. God had mercy on me. Yes, God had mercy on me. And there's light in this house now, so let's use our LED light to make our filling before we go to the dough. I'm still watching Auntie Flo's video. Have you? Okay, so I'm supposed to add time. So I'll be going in with my Maggie right now. So I'm going to go in with the thickener right now. I made this thickener with flour and water, so I'll just pour it into the mixture. May we just small inside this cooking so that the cooking will not be boring. I say my ass, who they follow gist lover? Eh? Who has been following gist lover? Like, yesterday night I was on gist lover's page for like nothing less than 4 to 5 hours. Hey! I was seeing the unseeable. The unthinkable sweet things I was seeing on gist lover. People are saying gist lover is a ghost. Who is gist lover? They need to catch gist lover. But I actually don't think gist lover is a ghost. I feel gist lover is she's a normal blogger that started exposing things that some celebrities do, or maybe she's a celebrity and she knows some inside gist. So she started exposing some things they were doing, and people now knew her for that. And then informants within the circle of different celebrities started selling their different friends out. Anyways, let's go over to our dough. I need to be very fast before Nepa will surprise me. So guys, this is the flour I'm going to be using. For some reason, I don't have this thing they usually use to measure flour. So I don't know whether this thing is even correct. I don't know, but I'll just add, like, I'm following Auntie Flo's video. I'm looking at how much her flour is. So I'm just using my sense to figure out something. I hope it's worth it. This society is really trying me. Ain't no hide and seek. So I'm going in with my salt now, just this little quantity. Say maybe we put salt. I beg, let me use my hand and put the salt. What is this? Thrown across every surface, it makes me nervous. It's the world honestly burning, that's all I'm learning. Hope that we can make a turn and start reversing. All our minds, you put the work in, we got some work, man. So guys, I think I have gotten this, like, it's non-sticky right now. It's no longer sticky. Can you see? My fingers, they pain me. Oh Jesus, this is where they do this for every day that they try. Maybe it's because I'm not used to it, but my fingers are paining me. Anyways, I'm done with this. So she said we should cover it. I don't have that nylon they used to use and cover things. So I'll just look for blue nylon and cover the plastic. So make I go find nylon now. So guys, I found everyday nylon, so I'm going to use it to cover this now. Hey, there are the baker. So yeah, I'm done covering the dough. She said we should allow it to rest for 10 minutes. So this is 2:51. So by 3:01, I'll bring it out and start kneading. Anyways, my rolling pin, I bought it last year. I've not used it for even one day. So it's going to come into use today. Oh, Jesus. See, very dusty and all of that. I'll wash it out now. I'll prepare the sides too. I'll be kneading on the sides too, so I'll clean it while we're waiting for the 10 minutes to get here. So I think before I start rolling this thing, I'll now start heating the oven. I think so. So let's do this. So it's now time to roll it out. Hey God, I'm actually enjoying this. So just that I wish I had someone that was filming for me instead of me to be the filmer. the director of photography, everything, all they know. So I'll roll this out now. Yo, did I even get this thing? I'm not sure. What are you doing now? So I just molded my first meat pie in the whole world. Hey, Jesus. This is an error. So I'll use this fork and give it that perfect meat pie shape. And I think some people used to put, when we did home economics in secondary school, you use your fork and do like this. Yay! Oh, so let's go over to the next one. So I didn't buy baking sheets. I didn't know I needed baking sheets until I watched her other meat pie videos. So she said you can rub margarine on the baking pan if you don't have baking sheets. So let's rub it and see how it goes. Signs, please, you're all too loud, you don't speak quietly. Opinions violently thrown across every surface. It makes me nervous. It's the world honestly burning, that's all I'm learning. Hope that we can make a turn and start reversing. All our minds, you put the work in, we got some work, man. So I'll be putting in the fourth one. I think there's little space for a last one, but just that it has to be small. So I'll do it because I need enough meat pies on this one before the next batch. I look exhausted already, but I'm actually exhausted already and I'm doing all of this alone. Anyways, here is my meat pie. Yeah, so I'll be taking it to the oven now. The oven is already hot and then I'll shape the other ones. I didn't expect this meat pie to come out this much. Oh my god. So my oven is preheated already. God, this thing is hot though. I think I need to cover my hand. So I'll just put this in. Did you guys see what I did now? I think it got blocked. Anyways, I've put it in. So I'll turn on the timer now. I'll leave it for 30 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. I'm not sure. I'll confirm from Auntie Flo's chicken pie video. So out of all the meat pies I made, I think the first one I molded is the one that had the perfect shape, even if I felt the shape was not nice. I'm actually seeing that the shape is the most perfect one, so I'm going to be tasting it first. Ah, I allowed this thing to get too strong. Anyways, let's open it. Can you see it? Can you see the color? And maybe I should have added more butter. Ooh, look at that steam. Ah, I made meat pie. I made meat pie by myself. Oh my god. So which side are we going to taste first? Let's taste this side first. Me no bum my mouth too. Not bad for a first timer, huh? But I can do better. I'll actually do better. Not bad, like, this is a perfect meat pie. But there's this type of meat pie, usually like this type that they sell at eateries. Most eateries. That one used to be very soft. I think they put excess butter. I think so, I'm not sure, I'm just assuming. I think they put excess butter. So next time I'm making meat pie, I'll put excess butter.
inside the part of the dough so that I'll see how it forms. Oh, this is nice. Wow. Wow. Auntie Flo, thank you. Who is the teacher? I have saved a lot of souls. Thank you so much. I think I'll go downstairs and go and buy a cold coke. I'd have made juice with this juice I have, but I don't have strength again. I just want that one to get done so I rest. I'm stressed.
So here's the second set, although I think two of them opened inside the oven because their dough was so thin, like I was trying to manage the dough because it was almost finished. So I was trying to manage it so that it would reach for two. And look at, I still later got a small one. I should have not managed the dough. I would have just used it to form a normal meat pie. But anyways, I prefer this one to the first one I made because it's actually soft. I'm not really a fan of the color. I think the butter I put was not enough. But you guys, that first one I ate was so delicious. Like, despite the fact that I felt it was too strong, that I left it in the oven for too long, it was very delicious. Like, so crunchy. Although, next time I'm going to add more butter and I'm going to make a better filling. But the filling was still okay and it was rich. In my mother's voice, the meat pie was rich. So yeah, here is our second set of meat pie. I'll be seeing you guys in my next video. If you enjoyed this video, do give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Share this video. Let's move this ministry to the permanent site. Iwatago. Yeah, I forgot to add, NEPA took lights like 10 minutes before this one got done. So it was in the oven, like it sat in the oven for like 2 hours before they restored power supply. Anyways, they restored power supply and here is our meat pie. So crunchy, I'm ready to eat it. I'll be seeing you guys in my next video. For now, bye, kiss kiss, love ya.